everyone, it's Steph here. Welcome back to the Novelty Corner and my What's on My Kindle Unlimited TBR video. In case you're wondering, I am day drinking, which is not my usual thing, but Victoria has gone back into stage 4 lockdown for 5 days. So if there's any excuse to have a drink during the day, it's today. And for anyone who's interested, because pretty much the only alcohol that I drink is gin. And I really don't actually drink all that often. Prior to last year, I might have been lucky to have had 2 to 3 drinks a year. And then last year happened and I just decided on a whim to start a gin collection because it's fun. So today I decided to have my favorite, which is this Margaret River Distillery. Oh, is it gonna focus? This is the Australian native gin. It's very tasty. It just seemed like a good idea because I'm gonna sit down and talk about some Kindle Unlimited books that I'm planning on reading hopefully in the near future and have a day of pretty much nothing because I'm not allowed to go anywhere. So for anyone who is unfamiliar with Kindle Unlimited, it is a monthly subscription service through Amazon. I know Amazon is the devil, but you know, let's go with it. And you can borrow out up to 10 books every month and they have a catalog of Kindle Unlimited titles so that you don't actually have to pay for the individual book. You borrow it and you read it and you return it and then you can borrow more books. Primarily in the past, I've used it mostly for novellas, but I do have currently 10 books loaned on Kindle Unlimited that I need to get to at some point. Some of them have been on there for a really ridiculously long time. But we're gonna go in order from the most recently added to my TBR to the ones that have been there the longest. The first book that I have is The Sweetest Fix by Tessa Bailey, mostly because it's Tessa Bailey and I really like her writing. This has only super recently been released. It might have been this month or at the end of January. And this is a contemporary romance about a woman who dreams of working on Broadway and she has an audition with a choreographer and she misses it. And after some advice from a totally random stranger, she ends up connecting with the choreographer's son and it's their romance. So I'm very curious to see what Tessa Bailey does with this, but I am very curious to try it. I also have Quarantine and Chill by Kenya Wright. This one I think I saw on recommendation from Steph from Steph's Romance Book Talk. I can't even remember if I said Steph's channel name right. Anyway, I'll leave a link down below. And she was interviewing Kenya Wright and talking about all of her books. And I suppose what's interesting about this one, it is a pandemic romance and it's about two people who end up living in the same apartment together and ending up in a relationship. But Kenya Wright includes illustrations in her books. And I was really fascinated by the conversation Steph and Kenya had around her work with the artist who does the artwork. And I thought it sounded really fun. So I'd really like to check this one out. And Kenya Wright is also a Black author. So I would really like to support her work. The next up is The Stopover, which is book 1 in the Miles High Club, which everyone was talking about at the tail end of last year and the start of this year. And I know in particular, I became really interested when Brie from In Love and Words was talking about this book. And then I found out that T.L. Swan is an Australian author. And so this automatically got bumped up because I want to do another Australian romance authors recommendation video. So I've been hunting around to find new Australian romance authors to try. This one is a billionaire romance story and it's about two people who meet on a plane and have a stopover and have this one night together. And then they get to their final destination and realize that the guy is the CEO of the company that the heroine is beginning work for. So I'm very curious to try this one and hopefully I'll get to it soon. The next one is Torch by Roxy Noir and I don't know where I saw this one. It is a contemporary romance and the hero is a firefighter who ends up saving the town that the heroine lives in, I think. I do really like the cover for this one. I think it's really pretty. Next up is Summer Return, which is Return to Me book 1 by Elise K. Ackers. I believe Elise Ackers is an Australian author and this is a contemporary romance story. The hero is returning to his hometown after many years away and it's not a great homecoming because he is not very well received in this town and he reconnects with a woman that he knew 8 years ago and as a kid she always had a crush on him, so it's their romance and that's about all I know. So I think it could possibly be small town romance. I'm not entirely sure. I'll let you know when I read it. Then I have The Only One Bed Volume 1 Anthology. This is a collection of 8 novellas that feature the only one bed trope. And the only two authors that I am familiar with in this anthology are Lucy Eden, who wrote Blind Date with a Book Boyfriend, which is another novella, and also Rebel Carter. So I'm very eager to try this one out because I believe there are 2 follow-up anthologies for Only One Bed as well. And if I like these ones, I would really like to pick those up because it's a trope that I do enjoy. I also have Pack Ebon Red, which is book 1 in the 7 Mates of Zara Wolf series. This is a polyamorous paranormal romance story with a heroine who is a werewolf, and that's all I know about it. I also have Pawn Star by Lauren Lynn Page and Sierra Simone because Hello, Sierra Simone. And this one has really good reviews, and I've heard a lot of people who I trust talk about this book and talk about it favorably. Every now and then I do see a book that talks about the industry, and they've all come at it with a really interesting perspective on it, and I want to see how this one compares to something, say, like Lingus by Mariana Zapata. So I am very curious about this one, and I'm hoping that it's going to be good. I also have The Failed Audition, which is book one in the Circus is Family series by Krista and Becca Ritchie. This was formerly called Amour Amour. It is a circus contemporary romance story. The heroine in the story is an aerialist who is trying to get a job in one of the circus shows in the Las Vegas Strip. I think I have seen it possibly in the blurb. It was described as Cirque du Soleil meets Center Stage, which sounds right up my alley. I love circus stories, and this one has been sitting on my KU shelf for a very long time, so I should pick it up. I do have a couple of circus books sitting on my Kindle, so I'm hoping at some point to maybe do like a circus themed romance vlog. So let me know if you're interested in that. And the final book that I have on my KU TBR is Woomy, which is the Outback Bachelor Ball book 2. This one is by Karina Bliss. Karina Bliss is a New Zealand author, but this story is set in Australia. It follows a heroine who dresses up as a cow on a joke to go to a BNS ball. There she finds more attention than she actually intended, and she crosses paths with a former ex-Special Forces soldier who is working security at the event, and it is their romance. All right. So that is everything that is on my KU TBR. Stay tuned, I'll hopefully be reading them at some point. I really do need to get better at reading these every month. In the comments below, let me know if there are any KU titles that you think I would be interested in. I'm always up for recommendations. I do keep a running list, and I go back and check things every now and then. Otherwise, I hope that wherever you are in the world, you're staying safe and healthy, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye, everyone.